What's up, y'all? Welcome to the channel. In today's video, we're gonna be working on the John boat.
So as y'all know, I'm gonna paint it old school, project old school here, and I got all the rivets welded except for the sides. And when last time I painted it, the paint gun messed up, so hopefully the new one will do good. But it's been a while since I messed with it, so we're gonna wash it off and go from there. The outside clean, scuffed and all. Here was where I had a line of flex seal. I may not even spray primer on it and worry about it, quite frankly, just because when I put Gator Glide on it, I'm gonna put a layer about right there, so I'm gonna have to sand it back to bare metal. Eventually I may redo this plate, but for now I'm just gonna scuff it up. The handles, I'm gonna scuff them and repaint them, and I'm gonna repaint the paddle to match it, so I gotta scuff it as well. I'm just gonna use some 220 grit. So the inside has been scuffed and whatnot, but I'm just gonna go over places where the welds are and scuff them up a little bit and wash it out. For the primer, I'm using Stikes River self-etching primer, and I got a couple cans of that. Trying not to bore y'all out with everything, but I got all the bare spots primed and scuffed, and I just wet it. And in a minute, I'm gonna wipe it down with acetone when the whole boat dries. Spray gun I'm using is from Harbor Freight. I also got the regulator and all from Harbor Freight. All the paint you'll see from today's video is from Stikes River. It's dove gray, mud brown, and fall brown, as well as desert tan. To thin the paint out, I'm using mineral spirits, and to wipe the boat down, I'm using acetone. Alright y'all, I got the base coat sprayed on, it's desert tan. I also got the handles painted as well as the paddle. The boat's looking pretty good. I know there's a lot of overspray on the bottom, but I'm not worried about that, because I'm going to have to go back and resand the bottom anyways to put the Gator Glide on there. I keep having all these phone troubles. My phone died, so now we're jumping to this, and now my phone's overheating. I got the front handle installed, and I got the transom boards and all put on the back. I gotta get the handles on, but I don't have bolts long enough. This is the only bolt I could find, and it's just barely too short, so we're gonna take a trip to Track Supply. Cheap and easy paddle holder. Here's how to do it. Get you some Velcro and some zip ties. Get the Velcro and then make sure it fits around the paddle pretty snug. Cut off any extra you may have. how you do it. And it'll keep it from going anywhere and keeps it out your way when you're in the boat.
Pattern was the biggest pain in the butt. It was like a puzzle piece for every single one of them.
Painful.
Yeah, it was slow. But thanks again, Caitlin. I appreciate all the help.
Anytime.
Couldn't have done it without you.
All right, y'all, this is how she's looking. She's almost complete now. In the video, got the boat painted, got the paddle put in there, got the handles on, then transom boards, got all that good stuff done. I did run out of tan paint on the inside, so I did miss some spots. And the paint, I've been having some weird problems with it. It's like it didn't quite dry like it should. You can see where it's chipped off in areas. I don't quite know what the deal with that is. It could be part of the humidity around here. When I sprayed it, it just didn't dry right. Not too sure.
There's not much left to do to this thing now. I'm gonna put some Gator Glide in it, on the bottom, I mean. And after that, I think that's about all I'm gonna do to this boat because I don't wanna go too crazy with it.
As y'all know, I did have the long tail on here. It's too much for this little boat. By the time you put two people in and some gear,
it'd just be real sketchy. So I plan on getting a bigger boat eventually, but for now it's gonna be like my little pond hopper boat, just stuff like that, maybe going in creeks and whatnot.
But this is the finished product for now, like I said, so I get Gator Glide on the bottom. I'm not gonna bother putting the light bar back on it. I got a cheap one off Amazon. It's super bright, just didn't hold up. But man, does that look good. I think next thing I may do, honestly, I might get some like sea deck to go on the top of the seats to match the transom, just to give the inside some extra color, because I feel like it's almost just too bland. It looks good, it's just I feel like it needs some offsets. Like I feel like the paddle helps a little bit, but pretty happy with it. First time ever doing this pattern, first time ever using this brand paint, so I'll just have to let y'all know what happens. I may eventually respray the inside with some tan to get kind of places I didn't have enough paint to get and touch up stuff. But I'm tempted to repaint it bottom land when this paint wears off.
As they say, better in bottom land, right? But I'm happy with how it came out. It's a good looking boat, I'd say.
Let me know what y'all think in the comments and give me any suggestions. I appreciate it, and I'll catch y'all on the next one.